The American people ranked their armed forces as one of the most respected institutions in US government. Unfortunately, we have some people within our ranks that abuse that respect. When members arrive to a new unit or reach a major career milestone, some of their fellow service members disguise abusive and humiliating practices as tradition or military heritage, or even required training. These practices are known as hazing. We have many time-honored traditions, but hazing is not among them. It has no place in our force. Hazing involves so-called initiations or rites of passage in which our people are subjected to physical or psychological harm to achieve status or inclusion. Hazing is not a constructive way to build unit cohesion. It is cruel, toxic, and demeaning. And hazing can cross another line and involve unwanted sexual contact and sexual acts. Let's get one thing straight. Sexual assault disguised as hazing is still sexual assault. These actions can force people to do things they don't want to do through verbal, psychological, or physical coercion. Let's be clear, hazing is not roughhousing or guys just being guys. People who engage in hazing are not teammates, and they aim to intimidate or humiliate members of the team for their own benefit. Any hazing is punishable under the UCMJ, but hazing that crosses the line of sexual contact is more serious and punishable as sexual assault. If it happens to you, it's hard to know what to do. Going along to get along is the easy route, but you know it isn't the right way. In the military, there are confidential resources available to help. You can speak to a SARC, chaplain, special victims counsel, or victims legal counsel about hazing that involves a sexual contact or assault. You also have access to a 24/7 safe helpline where you can be connected to skilled, certified professionals. They can assist or connect you to others who are ready to help without judgment. One call can provide access to resources on or off your installation. Hazing and sexual assault hurt both individual service members and the entire military and must be stopped. If you've been affected by sexual assault, you're not alone in this battle. You're among other brave warriors. Warriors with the courage to speak up and fuel change.